Well, our next guests are famous for their profiles of some of Hollywood's all-time greats. Katharine Hepburn, Judy Garland, Henry Fonda and Paul Newman have all been profiled by them. And they've won awards for their groundbreaking profile and documentary on Fred Astaire. Mm-hmm. Joan Kramer and David Heeley became friends with many of their interview subjects and they join us now live from New York.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Hi. Welcome to Studio 10. Wow, you must have a lot of celebrity goss on you. Let's start with James Stewart because you became friends with many of the stars from the golden age of Hollywood. But James Stewart.
James Stewart.
What was he like?
Joan.
Well, the thing is that it was a roller coaster ride to get him. First he said no, then he said yes, then he said no. And never underestimate the power of a wife. Because it was his wife. His wife said, you made a promise to these people and you have to keep it. So we finally, he said yes and it stuck. But it wasn't easy.
Oh, he was gorgeous. David, Paul Newman was one of your subjects and he didn't really enjoy the fame game, but he really loved a joke.
Yeah, he was one of those stars that actually didn't enjoy the spotlight on him all the time, but he knew how to use his fame, as you probably know from the Newman's Own salad dressing. All that money went to charity. But he was a bit of a practical joker, and when Joan would call Joanne Woodward, his wife, on the phone, Joan, tell him what happened.
Every time I called, he'd give me a different story, including once that that Joanne wasn't home, she was in Calcutta, India, doing summer stock, and I bought it.
I suppose, Joe, when he's saying that to you, it'd be pretty hard not to believe him, but you leave no stone unturned when it comes to research. Oh, yeah. And Joan, you went to incredible lengths to get to the truth about Judy Garland serenading President JFK.
Well, what happened is I wrote a letter to Jackie O'Neill. Liza Minnelli had told the story that her mother used to come home from a week of work taping her live show, and sometimes she'd call the White House, and she'd ask to speak to the president, and then she'd hear her mother sing the last eight bars of Over the Rainbow after she said to the president, you really want to hear that again? Okay, if you really want to hear it again. And so she'd hear her mother sing the last eight bars of Over the Rainbow. Well, we decided, because there was so much rumor and nonsense surrounding the life and times of Judy Garland, that we wanted to check it out. And the first thing I did was write to Jackie Onassis, who said the story is not true. And then I went from there, winding up with Caroline Kennedy, who led me to one of JFK's closest aides in the White House who confirmed that the story was true because he was in the Oval Office when the calls came in and the president would hold the phone away from his ear and say, listen to this.
Oh, my God. So that's what happens when you become president of the United States. You get Judy Garland to call you and sing Over the Rainbow. They're just amazing.
Anything you want.
they're just amazing stories, amazing personalities. Were you guys ever starstruck or did you just take it in your stride?
Look, you guys know this as well as we do. When you're working, you're not really starstruck. It's sometimes when you look back, you say, oh, my goodness, did that really happen to us? And that's kind of what happened when we were writing this book, because we were so busy at the time, we didn't realize. Well, we knew, of course. We knew we were in the presence of these major stars. But you're too busy working to be starstruck at that time.
And you worked several times with Katharine Hepburn, that great actress, including a documentary about Spencer Tracy. Now, everybody knows the couple had a very long and loving relationship, but she was always very respectful of Spencer Tracy's wife, wasn't she?
If you were an interviewer and you went to Katharine Hepburn and started talking about Spencer Tracy, the interview was over. This was something that all of Hollywood knew about. The gossip writers never wrote about it, unlike today when it would have been all over the place. Everybody respected that relationship was private. And then one day, Joan got a call from Katharine Hepburn. Joan, tell the story.
When you pick up the phone and you heard that voice, it was a bit of a shock, to say the least. And I heard, hello, Joan, it's Kate Hepburn. Now that I have friends at public television, let's do a show together about Spencer. Well, I have to tell you, my mouth dropped open, And I said, somebody's on my other phone. Could I please put you on hold for a second? How I had the nerve to do that, I don't know. But anyway.
Then Joan called me. She said, come here, Kate's on the phone. Kate's on the phone. I said, well, what's going on? She said she wants to do a show about Spencer. And I said to her, well, ask her if she'll host it.
So I got back on the line, and I said, I'm back. Would you be willing to host a show about Spencer Tracy? And she said, what the hell do you think I'm talking about? Come to tea tomorrow. Of course I should host it.
Oh, wow. Well, I just love how the stars' lives are intertwined with one another. Katharine Hepburn was filming with Henry Fonda, and then Michael Jackson drops by. It must be so surreal. You must have experienced so many of these surreal moments.
Well, we met Henry Fonda just after he'd finished On Golden Pond with Katharine Hepburn, and we were interviewing him about that experience. And it was very interesting because while the camera crew was setting up, I said to him, Mr. Fonda, can I just go through some of the questions just so you can get your thoughts together before we go on camera? And he said, of course, of course. I went through every question, he said, I don't think I've got anything to say about that. Let me put him down in front of the camera. Roll the camera, lights on, and suddenly, Henry Fonda, the movie star, was there. She was wonderful. She walked up to me and she said, it's about time. What an amazing transformation. But the story with Michael Jackson is a different one. Joan, you tell that one.
We were in Kepburn's house for lunch one day, and I saw a book on a table, and I said, is that your book? And she said, no, it belongs to Michael. And I said, Michael? And she said, oh, Michael Jackson, we're friends. And of course, you know, in her perfect timing, she's not a four-time Oscar winner for nothing. I said, you're a friend of Michael Jackson's? And she said, yes. And she says, here's what happened. Jane Fonda invited him up to the location in New Hampshire, and then she announces to me... And she announces to me that she had to go back to L.A. for the weekend, so she asked me to look after Michael. I didn't know him. So I went up to the room that Jane had found him in an attic somewhere of a house, and there were clothes all over the place, and I said to him, Michael, pick up these clothes. Don't you ever do your laundry? And in that little voice of his, he said, Miss Hepburn, somebody usually does that for me. She said, come with me. You're going to wash clothes. And she took him down the street to a local laundromat and taught him how to feed quarters into a washing machine while other people were washing their clothes.
Don't you wish there were cameras
there? I only had a camera.
Oh, my God.
Yeah. Wow.
Can you imagine that?
You know you've got some good stories when you're on first name basis with some of these big stars, Dean, Joan and David. Thank you so much for your time. We could talk to you all morning.
It's our pleasure.
And you can read all about these incredible stories in Joan and David's new book, In the Company of Legends. It's out today as both a hard copy as well as an e-book.